Hey guys, this is Justin Strawn, the managing editor here at For Whom the Cowbell Tolls. Appreciate you guys tuning in to this video that I'm making about how Mississippi State can get to the a New Year's Six bowl this year. There's been a lot of talk about how good this team is, how good they are not. Guys, this is a really good team. This is a solid team that has exceeded a lot of people's expectations. Yes, they had two bad losses. They lost big time to Georgia, and they lost in pretty convincing fashion to Auburn as well. But ever outside of those two games, this team has played very, very well. They played really well against LSU, beat them by 30, went on the road, beat Texas A&M. One thing that a lot of people thought this team couldn't do, go on the road and beat a quality opponent, and they went out and did that. Now, how quality of an opponent is Texas A&M? Well, I think we'll find out a little bit more about them a little bit later on in the season, but they're still probably going to be about a 7-win team, maybe 8, maybe, who knows, maybe they don't lose another one. It's not completely out of the realm of possibility that they could win the rest of their games, but it's going to be a difficult task. But this is a team that can get to a New Year's Six Bowl. This Mississippi State team has that possibility, and so let's take a look at the ways in which they can do that. Now, the first way in which they could get to a New Year's Six Bowl would be to simply win the rest of their games. Go 4-0 here in the month of November, and if they can do that, then they would definitely find themselves in a New Year's Six Bowl. They currently sit at number 16 in the college football playoff poll. They probably got to get to about number 11 at worst if they want to be able to do so. Getting all four wins here in the month of November would definitely do that. They would win this weekend against UMass, win against Alabama, win against Arkansas, win against Ole Miss. That definitely puts them in the top 10, and it would probably put them as the highest rated two-loss team in the country. So that would definitely be the easiest way to get to a New Year's Six Bowl. Now, would it get them into the college football playoff? Probably not, but you know what? If Mississippi State ends up beating Alabama next week, then we'll take a look at and see what it's going to take for Mississippi State to accomplish such a feat. So we'll look at that next week. Now, what else has to happen if you're a Mississippi State fan? Let's just assume, though, that they can't win all four. Now, I don't want to say that I am conceding the loss to Alabama. I'm not trying to say that Mississippi State has zero chance to win that game. There is a path to win that game. There are ways in which they can. It won't be easy. It won't be likely. It won't be probable. But it's not impossible. So I don't want you to think that I'm completely conceding that game. But let's just be real honest. Mississippi State's probably going to be about a 15-point underdog, if not heavier. And Mississippi State has already played two teams that can do the exact same things that Alabama can do in terms of stopping their offense, stopping their running game, and that was when they played Georgia and Auburn. And neither of those games went very well. I have a little bit more faith in the defense this time around when they take on Alabama, but let's just assume that things go the way most people think they will. Mississippi State loses to Alabama, and they can still make it to a New Year's Six Bowl. There is precedence for this. Now, then, one of the reasons why this is going to be possible, where it wouldn't be possible almost any other year, is because of the fact that the college football playoff semifinals are taking up a lot of the contractual obligations in the New Year's Six Bowls this year. Lots of times when there isn't a, when the Cotton Bowl and the Rose Bowl aren't being used for the semifinals, they end up taking a lot of spots from the top 12 teams simply because of the fact that they are contractually required to have certain teams. In the Cotton Bowl, I'm sorry, not the Cotton Bowl, the Sugar Bowl, we all know that the Sugar Bowl will always have an SEC team. They will always have a Big 12 team. That's just the way it works. Back to 2015, that's the reason that Oklahoma State and Ole Miss were both in there. I don't think either of them were in the top 12, but they both played in the Sugar Bowl because the Sugar Bowl has contractual obligations that they are going to take an SEC and Big 12 team. Look at Auburn last year in 2016. They made it to the Sugar Bowl, and they were well outside the top 12, mainly because the Sugar Bowl is contractually obligated to have an SEC team. Same thing in the Rose Bowl. In the Rose Bowl, you've got a team, you got two teams that are going to come from the Big 10 and the Pac-12. They always come from those two conferences. This year, you don't have that issue because of the fact that those two bowls are being used for the college football playoff. You basically have a wide open pool of at-large bids. Now, the only bowl in the New Year's Six bowls that still has contractual obligations is the Orange Bowl. The Orange Bowl is going to have an ACC champ, and they are going to pit them against either the highest ranked Big Ten or SEC team. That's the only thing that is contractually obligated in the remaining New Year's Six bowls. The Cotton, the Fiesta, and in the, which one am I forgetting? Cotton, Fiesta, and the Peach Bowl, those three bowls right there, guys, have no contractual obligations, so they will all be the highest rated teams that are coming in. The one caveat to that is the fact that the highest ranked Group of Five team, regardless of whether or not they are in the top 12, will be in a bowl, in one of those bowls as well. Right now, it's looking like Central Florida, who is the 18th ranked team. Assuming they went out, and most people expect them to do so, then they would be the college bowl. They would represent the Group of Five in a college, a New Year's Six bowl game, whichever, most likely the Peach Bowl is what people are assuming at this point. So, now, how can Mississippi State get to the point where they can play one of these teams in a New Year's Six bowl? Well, there obviously things have to go right ahead of them. Being 16th, they still got to get, let's just assume that there is going to be a Group of Five team that's ranked, because if Central Florida were to falter, you still got Memphis out there who's currently ranked as well. You probably got to get to at least number 11 in the country if they are going to do so. Now, they do have some things going in their favor. For example, Miami and Virginia Tech, that is the number 10 and number 13 teams in the college football playoff poll. They are currently playing this weekend. West Virginia is taking on Iowa State, who is number 15. Iowa State is headed to West Virginia this weekend, so that's a tough game for them. You've also got Oklahoma and Oklahoma State playing in Bedlam this weekend. That's a game that could help out the Bulldogs if the game plays out the way that you want it to. Now, in all these cases, if you want Mississippi State to climb up in the rankings, you need the lower seeded team to lose. For example, you need Virginia Tech to lose to Miami. You need Oklahoma State to lose to Oklahoma. That's the only way Mississippi State's going to be able to climb up. Auburn is going to take on Georgia next week. That's a game that you want Georgia, to win. So there are games that are going to be played that could send teams in front of Mississippi State lower into the rankings. And that's the first thing that has to happen. You've got to have some teams get beat. And there's going to be enough opportunities for teams to get beat simply because they are playing against other teams ranked higher than Mississippi State. Second thing you got to do is obviously take care of your own business. This weekend against UMass, you need to beat the Minutemen convincingly. When Mississippi State takes on UMass, it needs to be a complete and total domination. Mississippi State is favored currently by 28 points. I would like to see them win by about 35. If they can do that, that sends a message to the College Football Playoff Committee that, hey, this team is not going to mess around. They're getting, when they take on teams they're supposed to dominate, they do so. So you want to have Mississippi State completely overwhelm their opponent this weekend. And if they do, that's a good signal to the College Football Playoff Committee. Another way in which they can do that is when they take on Arkansas and Ole Miss, they need to win, and they need to win big again. They could very well be double-digit favorites in both games. Most of us saw that Ole Miss Arkansas game last week. There was nothing that really impressed anybody about either of those teams. So I really think that Mississippi State can go to both of those games, and win convincingly. Win by about 17 to 21 points in both of them, and you're probably sitting pretty good with the committee. Now, that leaves Alabama. Like I said earlier, if you just beat Alabama and win out, then you're fine. But what happens if you can't beat Alabama? What happens if everything plays out the way most of us think it will? How can Mississippi State still get to that New Year's Six Bowl? Well, I think the answer is to simply play them well and keep it close. We all saw back in 2014 when Mississippi State was the number one ranked team in the college football playoff poll. They took on the Alabama Crimson Tide. They played well. They weren't quite able to come up with a win, but they only lost by 5 points. Instead of dropping them out of the top four, they just dropped to number four. The committee recognized that Mississippi State was a good team. They just weren't quite as good as Alabama, so they kept them ranked in the top four at that time. Now, they ended up losing the game to Ole Miss, which sent them further down the rankings, but I really think that's one of the ways in which they can do it. If they can just keep it to around a two-score game, lose by no more than 10 or 14 points, I don't think Mississippi State drops that much, and they'll have more opportunity in the last 2 weeks of the season to make that up. If you're number 16 and you can go up a spot or two, get into the top 14, top 13 teams in the college football playoff poll, still play Alabama close in their game against the Bama Crimson Tide next week in Starkville, I don't see you dropping more than to round 5th, back to round 15 or 16. So if they can play well in that game, even if they lose, I think they still have a chance. And this is the way in which Mississippi State can get to a New Year's Six Bowl. It's a possibility. It's out there. It won't be easy, but they can do it. Now, like I said, if they just win all four of their remaining games, they'll be fine. They'll be sitting in the top 10 of the college football playoff poll. They'll be right where they need to. They might be the number two. They might be the highest ranked two-loss team. So there's a lot of possibilities, positive possibilities for Mississippi State as we go forward. So, until next time, we'll talk more about that game coming up against the Crimson Tide next week. Appreciate you guys tuning in. And until next time, Cal State.